What's going on, everybody? It's Nick Payne with Face Mask Fantasy, reacting to the news out of Las Vegas. The Las Vegas Raiders have released wide receiver Henry Ruggs. This happened later Tuesday night following a DUI charge that resulted in a car accident and the death of a 23-year-old woman. Ruggs faces charges of DUI that resulted in death. He faces a 2 to 20 year prison sentence. And from what I understand, this charge means probation is not an option for Ruggs by law in the state of Nevada. Now, before I continue, I just want to verbalize a disclaimer in the event maybe you're not a subscriber of ours or a regular listener of ours and just so happened to find this video. We are a fantasy football channel, so we are going to be reviewing the Henry Ruggs fallout from a fantasy football perspective. If that's not your interest, that's okay. I am totally fine advising you that you are safe to just move on. We are not really going to go into further specifics trying to dissect Ruggs' legal situation. All I have to say about Ruggs is this. It's an incredibly sad story for the woman who lost her life, and this was an extremely avoidable situation. It shouldn't have to be said at this point. Just common knowledge and common sense. Don't drink and drive. Ruggs killed someone. He took that person's life and has forever altered the lives of that person's family and friends. His career in the NFL should be over, and that would be the least of what is sad here. That's all I have to say about the situation. Again, incredibly sad situation for the person whose life he took. But to switch gears to a fantasy perspective, as ridiculous as that sounds, I'm going to do it. I'm going to try to do it. Ruggs leaves behind a 14% target share in the Raiders offense. He had 36 targets over 7 games, catching 24 balls for 469 yards and 2 touchdowns. Outside of Ruggs, the top 5 Raiders in targets are, in order, Darren Waller, Hunter Renfro, Brian Edwards, Kenyon Drake, and Josh Jacobs. Zay Jones only has 7 targets on the year, but could find himself stepping into a starter's role on the outside. Renfro can already be considered an every down player and figures to be the wide receiver who sees the biggest bump in looks. Ruggs' 5 targets per game figure to distribute between Waller, Renfro, and Edwards. I'd imagine Waller gets an extra 2 to 3 looks a game. Renfro and Edwards usually split the rest, and Drake might also mix in and see a slight bump in usage as well. Though targets left behind by a wide receiver would seem to filter primarily to other pure pass catchers in the offense. Still, Drake is seeing over 3 targets a game in his own right, and again, figures to be a bit more involved moving forward. Waller has been averaging about 7 targets a game since week 2. He hasn't been the clear-cut top 2 tight end he was being drafted as in most 2021 fantasy drafts. With more targets available in the offense now, this does figure to give him the biggest boost rest of season as Vegas' top option in the passing attack. Waller's got some great matchups left on the schedule to deliver an elite tight end finish. Renfro is still pretty widely available. He's available in 43% of Yahoo leagues, though that number likely goes up substantially following waivers this week. With at least 5 targets in every game this year, Renfro has low-end wide receiver 2, high-end wide receiver 3 appeal for the remainder of the season. He's primarily a slot guy and doesn't necessarily directly benefit from the targets left behind by a wide receiver who plays on the outside. But Renfro has 51 targets on the season. He's a big part of what the Raiders want to do on offense, and that role probably just expanded. In leagues where you start 3 receivers, he's officially on the radar moving forward. Brian Edwards has seen some consistent usage this year as far as targets, but he's only topped 50 receiving yards once since week 4. He did score his first touchdown of the year in week 7 just before the Raiders' bye week, so it's conceivable his workload bumps up as a mainstay playing as one of the outside wide receiver spots. For now, he's worth a speculative add if he's available on waivers. I probably wouldn't spend more than 5-7% of my budget though. He can't be started just yet, but he has an argument now to be rostered in most, if not all 10 and 12 team leagues. As I already mentioned, Kenyon Drake is now 4th on the team in targets, so his usage could be going up. He might not have standalone value with a healthy Josh Jacobs, but like Edwards, Drake is worth a speculative add if he was previously dropped. He could have some bye week fill-in appeal down the stretch, but he might be kind of touchdown dependent. Jacobs is 5th on the team in targets now. He was already in your lineup to begin with. Extra targets would be gravy for him, but that's not the primary reason why you have him on your team and in in your starting lineup. Extra passing game usage would be nice, but that's not been a big part of what the Raiders have asked of Jacobs since the team drafted him. And of course, we also have to just be cognizant of the intangibles of a fallout like this. Are the Raiders able to move past this as a group, mentally, psychologically, etc.? I'm not a doctor, I'm not a therapist, or any type of medical expert by any means. There's no way we can quantify this question or attempt to break it down, just throwing it out there, because this is a monumental development for a team with a 5-2 record that probably feels they're trending in the right direction. They'll have to rally around each other to overcome this, and how exactly that plays out is anyone's guess. For the team's sake and the individual player's sake, I hope they find a way. That's all I have as far as a Raiders pass catching breakdown after this development. What do you guys think? Put any thoughts you may have in the comment section below. We can have a conversation about this if you'd like. Till then, this is Nick Payne with Face Mask Fantasy. Thanks for listening.